Today we're going to talk about enumerations, or just enums for short. I'll show you with a practical example how it can be used in the context of a Laravel application. Okay, so if we look at the code, in one of the previous videos, which I will link below, we've set up the constant with our address types. Now we're basically going to convert this address type constant into an enum. Now this will help us be more flexible and be able to use that enum with the address types anywhere else in our application. Okay, so let's go ahead and define our enum. In the app folder, we can create a new folder called enums. And then in the enums folder, we can create a file called address types enum.php. And let's define our enum. Style of PHP tags, create it, and then we add into the namespace, which would be app / enums. And then we define our enum with the keyword enum, and the name is address types enum. And then we can define our cases, which would be our first case would be billing, second case would be delivery. And our last case would be postal. Now, this is what is called a basic enum. A basic enum is an enum without a scalar representation of its value. So, for example, if we want to compare this to a string value, it's going to fail because the two types are different. Now, the way around this is to set up a backed enum, but that is something we'll cover a little bit later. Okay, so let's dump this enum in the terminal to see what it looks like. I basically set up just a blank test so we can run PHP unit in order for us to see what it looks like. Address types enum, and we'll dump the first one, which is billing. And let's run PHP unit. And there we go. Now, as you can see, our variable or our enum, the type is address type enum. Then it's got automatically a property assigned called name, and that name of the enum is billing, and this corresponds to the first enum case called billing. Now we can also go ahead and call that name property on the billing like this and dump it out again to see what happens. And there we go, we can just get the name of the enum called billing. Now a backed enum is where I said you can give your enum a string representation. So let's go ahead and do this by saying billing equals the string representation is just billing, but all lowercase, just so we can see the difference. And delivery would be delivery, postal equals postal. Now, because we give it a string representation, we have to tell the enum that the return type or the backed type is going to be string. Okay, so let's go ahead and dump this out again. Let's just remove the name and dump it out. Okay, great. Now we can see we've got the enum, which is of type address type enum. And then we've got the name property, and we've got an extra value property. Now, this value property, we can basically change it to whatever we want. So if we only want to call it B for billing, D for delivery, or P for postal, we can do that. And then if we run our PHP unit again, we can now see that our value of billing has changed to B. Okay, so the first valuable enum method I want to show you is the cases method. This is basically a built-in static method that would return an array of all the cases in your enum. Okay, so now if we run PHP unit again, you'll see you get an array with all three of our enum values. Okay, so the next method I want to show you is from. Now, from takes in a string value and it tries to create an enum from that value. So for instance, if we pass it in, let's say B. Now, if it cannot resolve it, it'll throw an error. So as you can see, B is not a backed value. So the string value that you need to pass in is definitely case sensitive. So if we pass in capital B, we run it again, And now we can see it resolved our enum and it returned the billing enum. Now, sometimes when you use the from, you don't really want it to throw an error. So you would rather want it to return null. That's where you can use try from. So try from is different from from. So try from will resolve, if it cannot resolve your enum, it will return a null value. So let's pass in the lowercase b again, run our test, and now you can see it couldn't resolve it, it's returning null. And now if we change it back to a capital B, save our file, run phpNet again, and as you can see, it resolved our enum and returned our billing enum. Next, I want to show you a custom method that I like to implement whenever I create an enum. Okay, so let's go ahead and implement these methods. Let's start with the get values. So we'll define a new public function, and let's make it a static function so we can call it statically. And we'll type in the return type soon. We'll name it get values. And then we're going to return, and then what we want to return is a collection. So we'll use the Laravel collect helper to create a collection. And what we're going to do is we're going to take the cases, because remember the cases returns a collection or an array of enums. And then we're going to pluck the values from that collection. And we're going to return it. So basically, we're now going to return a collection of just the values. And then we can type in our return type as collection. Okay, so let's get back to our test and put this in action. So let's just comment this out. We'll keep it there for reference. And then what we'll do is we'll wrap this in a die and dump. Run our test and see what we get. Okay, we get null. That is because in the enum I, this should be value and not values. Simple typo. So if we run again, and there we go. We get our values from our enum, which is BDP, and we get a collection of BDP. Okay, so let's go ahead and implement our hasValue method by public static function, and let's say has value, and we want to receive the value as a string, and we want to type into it to return a boolean type. Okay, so next we can basically use the getValues method that we've defined earlier in order to check whether the value we pass in exists within the collection. So we can say self getValues. And then because this is a collection, we can now use the contains method to check whether the value exists. So the contains will return either true or false whether the value exists within the collection. Okay, so back in our test, what we can do is, let's say we want to check if our enum has a value of lowercase b. Let's run our test, and now you can see it doesn't exist because it doesn't have a value with a lowercase b. So if we change that to uppercase b, we run our test again, and you see it returns true. Okay, so that's basically it. Two simple methods that you can implement within your enum to make your life a little bit easier is get values that will return an it will return a collection of just the values, and then you can check whether an enum contains a certain value that you pass in as a string. Okay, so the last thing I want to show you is how we can extract these two methods into a trait, and then you can implement this trait within any enum you define. Okay, so what we do is in our apps folder, we define a folder called traits. And then in our traits folder, we can define one that says, let's call it managers enum values for PHP. And then let's set up our trait. Let's call it namespace equals app slash traits. And then trait. is manages enum values. And then basically we can just paste these methods in there. Make sure we import our collection. And now we can go back to our enum and we can define that it uses the manages enum values trait. All right, so if we run our test again, we should get true on this value. And then if we go on to, say, the lowercase b, run it again, we should get false. Okay, so now we've basically extracted these two methods into a trait, which we can reuse within any enum in our application. Okay, so what we need to do next is to actually replace the constant value we have, or the constant value we use in the custom validation rule, in order to use our new enum value with the has value method. Okay, so in the passes method of our custom validation rule, we need to replace this return statement. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to comment that out, leave it there for reference, and then we're going to return our address types enum, and then we're going to call this has value method on it. And what we're going to do is just to pass the value we receive from the validator to that method. Now this should then return the boolean value true or false. And now we can basically remove this private constant we defined in the previous episode. I will also leave a link in the description below to the video where we set up this custom validation rule. Thanks for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. See you later.